Here we have the range of professional composite shears available from Easy Composites. We have our 8 and 10 inch general purpose shears, our 10 inch Kevlar shears, and our composite snips. In this product spotlight, we're going to go over each one of these in detail, and I'll also cover some simple cleaning and maintenance information. First of all, these shears have exceptional build quality. They're manufactured here in the UK over in Sheffield by a scissor manufacturer who have been producing scissors since 1760. When you pick up, use and handle these shears, you really can feel that quality craftsmanship. A common feature that you'll see on all of these shears is the distinctive black appearance. Now this is a Teflon coating. Not only does that reduce the friction on the action, but it also provides a non-stick surface. So cleaning off any residue of resins after you're done is much easier than it would be if they were uncoated. Another key feature, and one that's exclusive to Easy Composites, is the grinding of the blades. Typically, the lower blade on a set of shears like this would be serrated, but we find that when you try and slide that serration underneath a fabric, it can snag and catch on the fibres, making a clean cut quite difficult to achieve. So instead, we have a smooth blade to allow it to slide underneath, but we still do have the serration, but on the upper blade, and that means that we get all of the benefit of the serration in terms of the grip on the cut, but we don't run the risk of snagging our fibre. We have these available in two variants. We have an 8-inch scissor and a 10-inch shear. Now, typically, I would use the larger 10-inch shear when doing kitting work on a cutting table and preparing fabrics. Then, when it comes to doing the moulding work itself, working in and around your mould tools, I would generally use the 8-inch scissor. The reason for this is the smaller size does make them a bit more agile, and having a longer shank here does provide a bit more leverage, meaning that you can cut multiple plies simultaneously quite easily. Looking now at the Kevlar or aramid specific shears, we have these available in both a right and left-handed version, and they're specifically designed for cutting Kevlar and other high tenacity fibres such as Enegra and Tuaron. Now, if you've ever tried cutting these fibres using conventional scissors, you'll know just how difficult, bordering on impossible, this can be, as the fibres tend to slide down the blade or get jammed between it. As an example, this is a 300 gram pure Kevlar cloth, which cuts quickly and cleanly using our Kevlar shears, but if I was to use a pair of conventional scissors, you can straight away see just how much more difficult this is. Even with these brand new scissors, I would struggle to cut more than a few centimeters before giving up. What makes Kevlar shears different is the pitch on the grind. You'll notice that it is much flatter than it is on the other shears. And this is advantageous in this situation because it puts more pressure onto the fibre and shears it more effectively. But this flat pitch does come with the disadvantage that it will blunten more quickly if used with abrasive fibres such as carbon and glass. So it is really important to reserve these only for use with Kevlars and other polymer fibres. Last in the lineup, we have the composite snips. These are a really handy tool for making small cuts and nicks down in intricate corners and areas during a prepreg layup. They're spring-loaded so that they can be used in one hand, and they feature a rounded, smooth tip, meaning that they're less likely to scratch a mould or release coating. So if you do a lot of intricate prepreg laminating, these would definitely make a great addition to your toolbox. All of these shears should offer years of daily service, but some basic care and maintenance will be needed in order to keep them in top condition. Probably the most important thing is to use them only for their intended purpose. Now, we've already covered the fact that the Kevlar shears should be reserved for aramids and other similar fibres, but you do need to avoid the temptation to use any of these for any other materials that may damage them. Even cardboard will blunten the blade more quickly than fibres would. Another essential thing is to keep them clean. Now, even though they are Teflon coated and cured resin will clean off them fairly easily, you should clean any uncured resin residue, including that from prepreg, using a suitable solvent, such as acetone or alcohol. Looked after, the blades will stay sharp for a very long time. But after a lot of use, if you do find that the blades are starting to dull, then they can be resharpened. Now, if this is not something that you can do yourself, you should be able to find a local blade sharpening service who can do this for you. When you do have them sharpened, you only need to sharpen the unserrated side, as this is a side which will dull much more quickly. The last thing to look at is the blade tension adjustment. Now, this is set with the pivot screw here and a lock nut on the reverse. From the factory, it's going to have a setting which is suitable for nearly all applications, but there still may be some instances where you might choose to change this. For instance, if you're cutting a very heavyweight fabric and it's getting drawn between the blades, you might find that increasing that tension will limit that problem. Inversely though, if you're cutting very lightweight fabrics, you might choose to slacken it to make the cutting action lighter and faster. So that covers our range of composite shears. I do hope this video has answered any questions that you may have had on these, but of course, if you are left with any, please don't hesitate to get in touch.